Hey, welcome to today's vlog. So, we all have ideas. We all have maybe opinions depending on a business and a product, entrepreneurship. But at some point, if you ask a friend, your friend, they always have an idea, a business idea per se. But then, like, what makes that idea such that if in case that is if which is a very big if because considering that over 70% of businesses fail within 5 years, majorly being on capital reasons like skills, maybe competition. So many businesses fail because of different reasons. But the major one that research shows is capital. Could be misuse of capital, lack of capital, yeah, something like that. So if you have an idea, as we always do, all of us have an idea on something in a different in an industry. Now, how do you move the idea from just the idea execution? Serving the customers and serving to the customer, that is. So you find that most of the ideas, or rather practically almost all ideas, have already been done, but you find ideas, businesses being started like every day. Today I was reading a book on how do you get your idea such that if you execute it, it will not fail. Because think of any industry. Of any industry, there's always the leading company. Then we have so many others below them. Or even if we talk of monopoly, there are companies that, yes, they could be having the largest market cap. But then there are companies that have smaller market cap still competing with the big elephant in the room. So, how do you get your idea rolling? Think of the Blue Ocean Strategy. The Blue Ocean Strategy is a book that was written by two professors, that's Reiner and Kim. And it majorly talks on, if you have an idea, how do you get the idea such that if it is a product you want to sell the customers, it has a higher value and a lower cost? You need to differentiate yourself in two ways. One, in the value that you provide, which must be higher than the competition, and then the cost, considering a lower cost. There's an example that I was reading, a case study rather, that was done by a company concerning a company by the name Wobbly Packer, depending on how you pronounce it. That's a glass or other an eyewear company. So the founder, one of the founders of the Wobbly Packer eyewear company, is Dave. His name is David. So David was traveling, and sadly, he forgot his sunglasses in the aeroplane or in the plane. But then, considering that the glasses that he had bought were, of course, prescribed because he had eye issues, were very expensive from Prada, costing over $700. So it came to him that it could cost him another $700 to get a new pair of glasses, and yet his glasses, of course, they were expensive, considering that the main leader in the eyewear is a global company that has all these other companies, fashion companies, under their wings, that they produce their glasses for them. Then the companies contract with the distributors who sell under their brands. So it was very disturbed, but then realized like, okay, this is a very big challenge, considering the eyewear are very expensive. Then distribution is not convenient or flexible. So he went and did some research, and considering that also majority of the people with eye issues cannot afford the glasses. It was very disturbing. So he came up with this idea of getting cheaper eyewear, convenient, and of course, being able also to meet the needs of those less fortunate to afford the eyewear, though they have eye issues or issues. So what he did with his team, they developed in seven designs. Not as compared to the leading company which had thousands of designs. Then they also came up with a package, or rather five pieces of glasses strategy. In the sense that if a customer ordered eyewear with the lenses that were prescribed, they would send five pieces, and then the five pieces from them, after taking a photo of the client and having the design, having getting the best design that could fit the client, then they could ship the five pieces. Then the client could try all of them, choose which one was best for the client that is. Then only then the client could pay for the selected eyewear, which was even. And then in terms of price, considering that the leading company was selling the glasses at US$700, the Warby Parker sells its glasses even as of now at only $95. Can see. Then, finally, in terms of the less fortunate, they came up with a mission to help that for every pair of glasses, it doesn't matter if the luxury or the one with the lenses sold, they also give one pair of glasses free pair of glasses to the less fortunate, or rather those who need them and are not able to afford them. And that's how Warby Parker is running right now, valued at 1.7 billion US dollars, doing over 300 million, 340 million dollars per year as of last year. That's very impressive, because now, as you can see from now, the Blue Ocean strategy that they took here is that they went the other direction. Less costly, more value, five pieces to choose from. And then the mission of helping people with eyewear issues was solved as well, or rather, they are trying to solve it. Rather than joining the competition of the leading monopoly company that produces the eyewear, they went the other direction where there was less competition. So, back to your idea. If you have an idea and you want the idea to want to start the idea, get the strategy, the resources, execute, get the customer feedback, and get the cycle all back running again, you need to consider the three strategies from Blue Ocean Strategy book. One, value innovation. In your idea, what is the value innovation for the end customer? Is it about cost? Is it about convenience? Then another thing, consider majorly capturing the cost. Cost in the sense that it doesn't mean that they have to be like free, but it means that they have to be affordable to the masses, or for the masses, that is. So, those two. You get those two right in your idea, then you'll be able to have the blue ocean strategy being able to help your business, to help your idea come into reality. So that book gives so many examples about the Nintendo, which is a Japanese video game company, how they took the strategy. Instead of targeting the kids, they went and targeted the adults in the game, such that now the whole home was involved in playing the game, and that's how they build the business to a multi-billion public company. If you only took three ideas or three things from this video today, is that if you have an idea, think of the blue ocean strategy. Considering, could be like, maybe in fashion we have 80%. This is just my numbers. 80 or 70% of the companies provide more of what can I say? More of young, or maybe millennial fashion. If you're considering of entering into the fashion industry, how about you consider a niche that is untapped, in the sense that the niche, because we find that most of the fashion consider clothing, less of shoes, maybe crochet, maybe hats, capes. How about you move into that and specialize in that? Then, only then, will you have your blue ocean strategy, because there's less competition, considering that most of the fashion they have like cover like a collection of all from all clothings, from shoes to trousers to sweaters to scarves, to name them. Consider a blue ocean strategy. Then what is the value that you bring? Is it custom made? What's the cost? And how do we deliver? Is it flexible? Like in this modern age, I think e-commerce should be at the center of your idea. E-commerce should be at the center of your idea. How do you get the idea into a product, and then the product to your customers' hands? E-commerce should be the center of your idea. I'll be talking more on e-commerce maybe within this week on how do you get your idea into e-commerce. Then from e-commerce, that e-commerce basically is not only marketing or other digital marketing per se, but it's more of payments. It's more of a branding. Now that's the packaging. How do you package your product? Is more of the payment gateway could be M-Pesa, could be, that's in our local country, could be the M-Pesa, could be the PayPal, could be the credit companies, Master, Visa, name them, MasterCard. The logistics that go into that, because if you sell a product online and somebody orders it from another country, you need to think of the logistics to deliver the product to the customer. Could be of the of course, as I've said, more of marketing, payments, logistics, then the product itself. Of course, because it's a product that somebody cannot test at that point to see if it suits them, if it's a cloth, cannot try it out, you need to consider very important on the quality of the product, such that you have less and less returns. So I'll be moving into e-commerce, mostly talking on e-commerce, marketing, and of course books. So the book for today, Blue Ocean Strategy by Kim and Rene. They are professors. Hope this video is helpful to you. Share it out to your friends. Subscribe to my YouTube channel if you find value in it. And if you have an idea, drop it on the comment. Maybe I might have something to say about it. Maybe critique it with my naivety. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Follow me on Instagram as Okerosi Davis, LinkedIn as Okerosi Davis, where I'm very active. Follow me on TikTok as Okerosi. I'm very active as well there. And Facebook as Okerosi. Okerosi. See you soon.